Hello everyone, myself A.S. Falmari, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In the last video, we have started to study Lagrange's Undetermined Multiplier. In that video, we have seen the method of Lagrange's Undetermined Multiplier and few examples. Now in this video also, we will take some more examples. Now the learning outcome is, at the end of this session, students will be able to find the stationary values of given functions subjected to some conditions. Now, pause this video and answer this question: what is the volume of a rectangular solid? I hope that all of you have written the answer. Now, the problem is, what is the volume of a rectangular solid? If W is a width, H is the height, and L is the length of that rectangular solid, then the volume of this rectangular solid is given by V equal to product of the width, height, and the length. Now consider one example. Show that the rectangular solid of maximum value that can be inscribed in a sphere is a cube. Now, here we have to show that the rectangular solid of maximum value that can be inscribed in a sphere is a cube. Okay, so the given function is a rectangular solid. We know that it has the width, height, and length. Let us assume that 2x, 2y, 2z be the length, breadth, and height of the rectangular solid. And the subjected condition here provided is that the sphere. So we know that it has a radius. Let us assume that r be the radius of this sphere. Now, just we have seen the volume of a rectangular solid, which is provided by the product of the length, breadth, and the height. Now, these are the length, breadth, and the height, and it is equal to 8 into x, y, z. Now, we will denote this function by f, that is equal to 8 into x, y, z. Now, call it as equation number 1. Now the subjected condition is a sphere. Now the sphere centered at origin has the equation x square plus y square plus z square is equal to r square. Let me write it in a standard form. Let me denote it as phi of x, y, z equal to x square plus y square plus z square. Taking this r square to the left hand side, we get it as minus r square is equal to 0. Now call it as equation number 2. Now here, as that f and phi are functions in three independent variables, we are having these three Lagrange's equations. Consider the first one. Now the partial derivative of this function f with respect to x, treating y and z are constant, is 8yz plus lambda times. Now phi is x square plus y square plus z square minus r square. Its partial derivative with respect to x, treating y and z constant, is simple 2x. So here it is 2 into lambda x equal to 0. Now call it as equation number 3. Now the next equation is dou f by dou y plus lambda times dou phi by dou y equal to 0. Now it implies, now differentiating f partially with respect to y, the derivative of y is 1. Now the 8xz as it is plus, now lambda times partial derivative of phi with respect to y is 2y. Therefore it is 2 lambda y equal to 0. Now call it as equation number 4. And the last equation is dou f by dou z plus lambda times dou phi by dou z equal to 0 implies, now the partial derivative of f with respect to z is 8xy plus, and lambda times the partial derivative of phi with respect to z is 2z, that is equal to 0. Now let us call it as equation number 5. Now from the equation number 3, we can write it as 2 lambda x equal to minus 8yz. Remaining equation can be written like 2 lambda y equal to minus 8xz, 2 lambda z equal to minus 8xy. Now actually our aim is to eliminate the parameter lambda and obtain the values of xyz. Multiplying this equation by x, we get it as 2 lambda x square equal to minus 8xyz. Let us call it as equation number 6. And to the next equation, multiplying by y, we get it as 2 lambda y square equal to minus 8xyz. Call it as the next equation number 7. And to the final equation, multiplying it by z, we get it as 2 lambda z square equal to minus 8xyz. Now call it as equation number 8. as in 6, 7, 8, right-hand sides are equal, we can equate the left-hand sides. So after equating left-hand sides, we get the equation 2 lambda x square equal to 2 lambda y square equal to 2 lambda z square. Now it implies after removing 2 lambda, that is by dividing by 2 lambda, we get it as x square equal to y square equal to z square. Now here x, y, z are the length, breadth, height, therefore they are always positive. So that now it will implies that x equal to y equal to z. Now that whatever may be the quantities x, y, z, height, length, breadth we have considered, that are all are equal. It means what? That rectangular solid is nothing but a cube. Now it proves a rectangular solid inscribed in a sphere is a cube. Consider the next problem. Find the maximum and minimum distances from the origin to the curve 3x square plus 4xy plus 6y square equal to 140. Solution: here we want to extremize the distance, and we know that the distance of any point x comma y from the origin is given by d equal to under root of x minus 0 square, that is x square, plus y minus 0 square is y square. Now we have to extremize this condition subject to this curve. Now extremizing this distance is exactly equivalent to extremizing its square. Now taking square on both sides, we get d square equal to x square plus y square. Now let us denote this function by f, which is equal to x square plus y square. Now let us call it as equation number 1. Denote the given condition curve by phi equal to 3x square plus 4x into y plus 6y square minus 140, after taking 140 to the left hand side, is equal to 0. Now let us call it as equation number 2. Now here the functions are in two independent variables, therefore we have two Lagrange's equation. First one is dou f by dou x plus lambda times dou phi by dou x equal to 0. It implies differentiating this f partially with respect to x, treating y constant, we get it as 2x plus lambda times differentiating phi partially with respect to x, treating y constant, we get derivative of 3x square is 6x plus derivative of 4xy is 4y, and the derivative of remaining constant is 0 and it is equal to 0. Call it as equation number 3. Consider the next equation, dou f by dou y plus lambda times dou phi by dou y equal to 0, which implies now differentiating f partially with respect to y, treating x constant, we get it as 2y plus lambda times differentiating phi partially with respect to y, treating y constant, we get it is a constant, its derivative is 0, derivative of 4xy is 4x plus derivative of 6y square is 12y, and the derivative of constant is 0 and it is equal to 0. Let us call it as equation number 4. Now from these two equations we can observe that it is possible to obtain the value of lambda in terms of xy. Therefore from 3 we get the value of lambda as minus 2x upon 6x plus 4y. Now from the denominator it is possible to take 2 common and it is possible to remove it. So we get it as minus x upon 3x plus 2y, call it as equation number 5. And from the equation number 4 we get the value of lambda as minus 2y upon 4x plus 12y. Again from the denominator we can take 2 common and we can remove this 2 from the numerator and denominator. We get minus y upon 2x plus 6y. Call it as equation number 6. Now from 5 and 6 we can see that both are the values of lambda, therefore they must be equal. Therefore we can write lambda equal to minus x upon 3x plus 2y is equal to minus y upon 2x plus 6y. Now let us multiply by minus throughout the equation. We get minus lambda is equal to x upon 3x plus 2y is equal to y upon 2x plus 6y. Now for this term, multiplying and dividing by x, we get minus lambda equal to x square upon 3x square plus 2xy. And to this quantity multiplying and dividing by y, we get y square upon 2xy plus 6y square. Now let us adding these two quantities, we get minus lambda equal to x square plus y square upon 3x square plus 6y square plus 2xy plus 2xy is 4xy. Now we can see that this x square plus y square is nothing but f from equation number 1, and 3x square plus 6y square plus 4xy is the curve, and it has the value 140 from the equation number 2. That is the value of lambda we have obtained minus f upon 140. From equation number 3, after substituting the value of lambda, we get 2x minus lambda is f upon 140 into the bracket 6x plus 4y is equal to 0. Now multiplying by 140 to out this equation, we get 280 into x minus 6fx minus 4 into f into y is equal to 0. Now again dividing this equation by 2, we get 140 into x minus 3f into x minus 2f into y is equal to 0. Now from the first two equations, we can take x common, and inside the bracket, the left quantity is 140 minus 3 into f into x minus 2fy as it is equal to 0. Call it as next equation number 7. Again, substituting the value of lambda in equation number 4, we get 2y minus f upon 140 inside the bracket 4x plus 12y equal to 0. Again, simplifying in the same manner as we have simplified here, we get it as minus 2f into x plus inside the bracket 140 minus 6 into f into y is equal to 0, equation number 8. From the equation number 7, we can get the value of x as 2 into f into y upon 140 minus 3 into f. Now, in substituting it in equation number 8, we get this minus 2 into f, and here the numerator is 2 into f into y, we get it as minus 4 f square into y upon 140 minus 3 into f plus this remaining quantity inside the bracket 140 minus 6 f into y as it is equal to 0. Now multiplying this equation by 140 minus 3 into f upon y, we get minus 4 into f square plus 140 minus 6f into another bracket 140 minus 3f equal to 0. Now simplifying bracket, we get minus 14f square minus 1260 into f plus 140 square equal to 0. Again simplifying the above equation, we get f square minus 90 into f minus 1400 equal to 0. Now it is a quadratic polynomial in f. Its roots are f equal to 70 comma 20. But the actually f is a d square, that is it is a square of the distance. So the actual values are root 20 and root 70. Root 20 is the minimum one and root 70 is the maximum one. Therefore, we can say that the maximum and minimum distances are root 70 and root 20 respectively.